Hello friends, welcome to Lucid mains program by new IAS. Today we will deal with a new topic which is very important in our quality paper for the mains, that is article 35A. So what is article 35A? Article 35A of the constitution empowers Jammu and Kashmir legislature to define permanent resident of the state and provide special right and privileges to them. Actually, this is how we can say simply. Before getting into the details, let us see why it is important for us or why we need to focus on it. In 2014, an NGO, We the Citizens, challenged Article 35A on the ground that it was not added to the Constitution through an amendment under Article 368 and it was never presented before the Parliament. But actually, this was incorporated into the Constitution in 1954 by an order of the then President Rajendra Prasad on the advice of Jawaharlal Nehru Cabinet, under Article 371D of the Constitution. And this provision allows the President to make certain exceptions and modification to the Constitution for the benefit of the state subject of Jammu and Kashmir. And the court also observed that the President may modify an existing provision in the Constitution under Article 370 and thus held the validity of Article 370 in Sambat Prakash case. But the question here is whether the President can introduce a new article without the Parliament's knowledge or not. Here, even the court remains silent and the question remains yet to be answered. In another case in Supreme Court, two Kashmiri women argued that state law from 35A had disenfranchised their children, that is, deprived of their right, privilege, etc. Actually, earlier, women would be disqualified if they married a non-permanent resident. But Jammu and Kashmir High Court held that they will not lose their right if married to a non-resident, but the children of these women will not have succession right. So this issue also need to be solved. So now, considering the sensitivity of this issue, Supreme Court referred both this petition to 3-judge bench and decided that validity of Article 35A and Article 370 may ultimately be decided by the Constitution bench. So that is why we need to focus on this issue. And now let us check the history or background of this issue. In 1927, Jammu and Kashmir was the only state with a Muslim majority which was ruled by a Hindu king. It had border with both India and Pakistan. Based on British partition plan, it could either stay with India or Pakistan, but Jammu and Kashmir opted to stay independent. But when Pakistan-sponsored tribal forces attacked Jammu and Kashmir, Maharaja acceded Jammu and Kashmir to India in 1947. After the accession, a popular leader, Sheikh Abdullah, took over the reign from this Dogra ruler, and in 1949, he negotiated with the New Delhi, which led to the inclusion of Article 370 in the Constitution. This Article 370 provides special status to Jammu and Kashmir, restricting union legislation over defense, foreign affairs and communication. And in 1952, under Delhi Agreement between Abdullah and Nehru, several provisions were extended to Jammu and Kashmir via presidential order in 1954. Thus, Article 35A was inserted. So, now let us check the Article 35A in detail. As I said, it empowers the Jammu and Kashmir legislature to define permanent resident of the state and provide special right and privileges to them. This article prohibits non-permanent resident of the Jammu and Kashmir from permanent settlement in the state and from acquiring immovable property, government job, scholarship and aid, etc. So, according to the Jammu and Kashmir Constitution adopted on November 17, 1956, permanent resident is a person who was a state subject on May 14, 1954 or who has been a resident of the state for 10 years and has lawfully acquired immovable property in the state. Jammu and Kashmir legislature can alter definition of the permanent resident only through a law passed by 2/3 majority. And next provision is, it also denies property right to woman who marries a non-permanent resident and her children, as I told earlier. So these are all the provisions of Article 35A. Now let us see arguments in favor of Article 35A. First one is, abolition of 35A will dilute the autonomy granted under Article 370 in the Constitution, and it will breach UN resolution. Jammu and Kashmir is a part of India, but according to Security Council 47, which is still in force, the status of the state is still an open question under international law. According to UN Resolution 47, state's accession to India is an open question subject to a plebiscite. This will be conducted by UN, but as the condition for that plebiscite is still not fulfilled so far, so this plebiscite has not been conducted. Hence, the decision is still pending. So, taking a decision like repealing Article 35A may backfire on India as it will dilute the autonomy of the state. Then, it will alter the demography of the state if it is repealed. So far, after 70 years, the demography of the Jammu and Kashmir has not changed much. Not only demography, their cultural identity also will be in peril. That is mainly the culture of Dogra community. Next is the external security issue. This kind of turmoil will cause security issues as Pakistan may try to take advantage of this opportunity. And our border with China and Pakistan will also become more vulnerable. Then about the internal security issue, repealing of Article 35A will further the violence and agitation, which will give a way for increasing militancy and separatist activity in the state. And the work opportunity for local skilled and unskilled labor will shrink due to increased competition from outside. And there will be immense pressure on land holding for settlement if acquisition of property restrictions are lifted. And if we are taking acquisition of property restriction alone, there are other states which says that no to an outsider to buy land like Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, etc. And youth also will be deprived of concession in the recruitment in the security forces and education, job, and also will have to face strong competition in all this area. So, these are the arguments in favor of Article 35A. And next, let us see arguments against the Article 35A. First is the gender discriminatory provision. As I said earlier, if a woman marries a non-permanent resident, her children will be denied of succession right. And also, this violates the fundamental right of residents of state who are not permanent resident but are citizen of India. This violates Article 14, 19 and 21 of the Constitution. That is, Article 14 is right to equality, 19 is right to freedom and 21 is right to life. Then, in arguments in favor, we discussed about the how 35A is protecting demography. Ironically, Article 35A, which was meant to protect the demographic identity of the Kashmir, failed to act against one of the most significant episode of ethnic alteration, that is expulsion of Kashmiri Pandit. So it was not fully successful in protecting demography. Then it will boost the economy because of open investment and will accelerate the development in the valley. Then many sections like Valmiki community and other SCST community are deprived of their deserved benefit as they don't fulfill the permanent resident of criteria in the state. And finally, it is against the very spirit of oneness of India, giving more room for divisive politics. Then that's all about the arguments against Article 35A. So next is the way forward. Both center and state legislature can address sensitive issues like gender discriminatory provision and considering backward classes, etc. instead of repealing this article completely. State can also take initiative as the state can make changes by having a two-third majority. Then integrate the people of state with the rest of the country using various programs like Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat, etc. So once they feel safe and homely in other parts of India and are competent enough to face the people for job and education, the relevance of Article 35A will gradually be reduced. Then focus on development of the states like promoting tourism, promoting investment and other sector, etc. Then create more employment opportunities for the youth so that their energy won't be diverted to divisive politics and militant activities, etc. So this is about the way forward, and that's all about Article 35A. Thank you.